Welcome to the Prep Athletics Podcast. This is Corey Heights.
Some battles. I'm not sure if they got us. If they did, maybe.
So you will get better as a player during that year.
So it was kind of exciting. Like, oh yeah, somebody wants me.
Yeah. Let's talk about money and tuition. So obviously there's scholarships out there. Explain the scholarship situation from, like, you know, in Indian Hills all the way down to maybe a Division II junior college. And then explain, like, if you don't get a scholarship, like, do you get Pell Grants? Do you get academic aid? And what would be the full tuition if you had to pay it for a year at one of these places?
Yeah. Indian Hills is kind of the model of the highest level, right? Think of Indian Hills like Duke. And so, you know, at Indian Hills, you have all the resources, summer school, summer housing, full scholarship at every spot on that roster. All 15 spots are full scholarship, food, everything. You keep your Pell. So if you're a Pell Grant qualifier, you get to keep that. You know, the school doesn't take it. Then once you kind of go down from that, it gets super diverse. And every school is different, even if it's a Division I school. Not all Division I schools are 15 full scholarships. At McCook, there are five or six full scholarships, and he'll split those sometimes, you know, and then if you're a Pell kid, you know, some of that money goes towards covering the rest of that cost, you know, whatever it is. And it's a pot of money that ends up being divvied up amongst the spots and depending on how you are as Pell and all that. The good part is that generally junior college is relatively inexpensive. So if you are a full Pell kid, there are some situations where if you're a full Pell kid, they'll take your Pell money, but you don't owe anything else. Like, it only costs $6,000 or $7,000 to go to school for the year.
What's the max a kid can get with a Pell Grant?
I think 6,800 is what it's at right now.
Okay.
For the year.
And that depends on their financial situation of how much they can get. Okay.
Yep. And so, you know, everybody's really different. Des Moines Area Community College, Brett Putz does a phenomenal job there. And actually, you and I talked about that spot earlier this year. And so he doesn't have a bunch of fulls. He's got, you know, covers a large amount of it. But if a kid is academic, they can get them academic money. If a kid's a Pell kid, that'll cover stuff on the back end. But even if you're not a Pell kid and you don't have academic money and all that sort of thing, the cost is still pretty cheap, like, you know, what? Even with a partial scholarship. I mean, I think to go to McCook, which is, you know, Division One, great facilities, all that sort of thing, I think their total cost for the year is like $8,000 for like everything.
And I guess a kid could get a loan too if they needed it.
Yeah, because it's
they work studies at junior colleges as well.
They do work studies. Okay. They do, you know, just even outside of the work study, there's a lot of them that'll help guys get jobs. You know, I was talking to a coach this morning, and there's three kids that are going to go back for the summer to put in, you know, the extra, rather than go home, you know, they're going to take advantage of the facilities and be able to live on campus and stuff. And they're going to just get them a job and they'll work this summer and, you know, all that sort of thing. So everybody, it's a very diverse system. So extremely important when you're talking to coaches, understand that not all opportunities are created equal.